I'd have to say that during the years that I broadcast baseball in Buffalo, the one manager whom I think I like the most as a guy was a man named Kirby Farrell. He sat one night and he said to me, "I managed the major leagues for only 1 year." He said, "I thought I did a pretty good job, but I had an accident, not to me, but probably the best pitcher in the American League. My lefty, Herb Score." Then one day we were playing against the New York Yankees. Somebody hit a line drive, hit him right in the face, and that was the end of my career. I remember Kirby for that, and for one other thing. Had a shortstop in the spring training by the name of Bobby Wine. Played in the major leagues later. But Bobby had been hit in the head by a pitched ball, and he batted almost outside the batter's box. He really just had fear of the ball. Came up one day during the regular season, and he got the hit and run sign. Now, when somebody gives you a hit and run sign, you can't jump out of the batter's box. You got to hang in there and hit the ball. And Wine did, and he got a single, and he got the first base. And he realized there was nobody on base. Might have been the only time in the history of baseball that a manager gave a hitter the hit and run sign with nobody on base. But Wine never again was kind of fearful of the ball. Became a pretty good major leaguer. You could thank Kirby for it. Kirby, 1 year in the major leagues, his best pitcher, maybe the best pitcher in the American League, gets hit by a batted ball, and it's the end. I'm Bill Mazur.